The Bank of Canada has a monetary policy framework that aims to keep inflation low, stable, and predictable. The inflation target is 2%, the midpoint of a 1 to 3% range. The bank uses its policy interest rate, also known as the overnight rate, to influence short-term interest rates and affect spending and borrowing decisions in the economy. By adjusting the overnight rate, the bank can stimulate or restrain economic activity and inflation. But what are the benefits and risks of using these tools and policies? And how do they impact different sectors and groups in the economy? One benefit of inflation control is that it helps money keep its value and makes it easier for everyone to plan how, where, and when they spend. For example, companies are more likely to invest and create jobs when they know what their costs and revenues will be in the future. Consumers are more likely to save and spend wisely when they know how much their money will be worth in the future. Low and stable inflation also supports international trade and competitiveness by reducing uncertainty and volatility in exchange rates. Another benefit of inflation control is that it helps prevent inflation expectations from becoming unanchored. Inflation expectations are what people think inflation will be in the future. They influence wage and price-setting behavior and can affect actual inflation. Inflation targeting plays an important role in ensuring people continue to expect inflation to be around 2%. And when people expect inflation to stay under control, they act in a way that tends to bring that about. People will shrug off short-term changes in prices if they believe inflation will remain low in the long run. However, inflation control also involves some risks and trade-offs. One risk is that the bank may not be able to achieve its inflation target at all times due to unforeseen shocks or structural changes in the economy. For instance, global events such as wars, pandemics, or natural disasters can disrupt supply chains, affect demand, and cause inflation to deviate from the target. The bank may have to tolerate some temporary fluctuations in inflation in order to avoid excessive volatility in output and employment. Another risk is that the bank may face a situation where its conventional policy tool, the overnight rate, reaches its effective lower bound, ELB, which is close to zero. This means that the bank cannot lower the overnight rate any further to stimulate the economy and fight deflationary pressures. In such a scenario, the bank may have to use unconventional policy tools, such as quantitative easing, QE, or forward guidance, to provide additional stimulus. These tools are less well understood and may have unintended consequences for financial stability or market functioning. A trade-off that the bank faces is between achieving its inflation target and supporting other objectives, such as economic growth, employment, income distribution, or environmental sustainability. While low and stable inflation generally supports these objectives in the long run, there may be short-term conflicts or tensions between them. For example, lowering the overnight rate to boost economic activity may also increase household debt or asset prices, which could pose risks to financial stability. Raising the overnight rate to cool down an overheated economy may also hurt some sectors or regions more than others, which could widen income gaps or regional disparities. The Bank of Canada tries to balance these benefits and risks by adopting a flexible approach to inflation targeting. This means that the bank does not focus on hitting the 2% target at all times, but rather on returning inflation to target over a reasonable time horizon, typically between 6 and 8 quarters. This allows the bank to take into account other factors that affect economic welfare, such as output gaps, financial imbalances, or distributional effects. The bank also communicates clearly and transparently about its policy decisions and expectations for future inflation and growth. In summary, controlling inflation is not an easy task. It requires careful analysis of economic data and indicators, sound judgment of current and future conditions, effective communication with the public and markets, and constant evaluation of policy outcomes and impacts. The Bank of Canada strives to achieve its mandate of promoting the economic and financial welfare of Canadians by keeping inflation low, stable, and predictable.